Tom.
Ban. Welcome, everybody.
To this thing.
It's Tom and Ben.
You can all stop clapping now. We're back.
You can now stop clapping. Very good.
Well done.
Thomas, holes in his shirt. Yeah, I do. You can see straight through me. Holes in my bod.
Hot bod holes. That sounds weird.
Hot bod holes?
Yeah.
You can have a go on my hot bod holes, Ben. Look, if you put your hand behind me...
There's my hand. I'm going to poke you through the holes.
Oh, Ben. Please. Oh. Anyway, just to really just set the tone of how this whole fucking thing is going to go.
I've got mega loud music. I don't know about the stream. Okay.
Oh god, that got louder.
Stop, TJ!
Wait.
You're fading into the void, Tom.
God, those, okay, 1,000 points to whoever can remembers the name of the disease that was in Judge Dredd, where it's almost like kind of like puzzle pieces kind of like disappear from your body. Like a big like chunk will disappear, but like your forearm could disappear, but your hand is still connected, and then it just keeps going until you disappear and you turn into like a ghost.
Jigsawitis.
Something like that, but it wasn't a puzzle piece. Was it just jigsaw syndrome? I don't know. Because it wasn't like a puzzle piece. It was kind of like blocks.
That sounds like a Judge Dredd thing.
Jigsaw syndrome.
Maybe not. 2000 AD. Pixel Man.
Is that the guy with it? Look there. These are the dudes. Like...
Oh, that's horrible.
Maybe he's just the Jigsaw Man. Maybe it was Jigsawitis. He's got, like, sexy pants on, but yeah, I think it's fine.
Main screen, activate!
Main screen, turn on! No, it's main screen, go! maybe it was Jigsawitis.
This looks horrible. I don't want it. So does that part of your body stop existing, or can you just, like, see through it?
It stops existing, but it is still there, because, like, his leg, he can still walk, but... Just
right.
A chunk is gone.
Does more of you go, or is he just this is how he is now?
It keeps going until
you stop existing. But you are still sort of there, right? If your whole body's got jigsawed,
yeah.
But you would actually still be there, but you couldn't touch or be seen.
Exactly.
But maybe you could still see. You're in like the nether realm.
Oh, like a ghost.
You'd basically be a ghost, wouldn't you?
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
I forgot how small their little teeny guns are in the comics.
Yeah, but they pack a punch, Ben.
Yeah. They've got the hot shot.
I was watching a video about sci-fi guns.
Oh, yeah?
A YouTube
video. What's the best sci-fi gun?
Well, God, like, you know, you just there'll be a sci-fi with just the Doomsday pistol.
Oh, the mega gun that kills everything automatically. What's your favorite?
So, of the ones, the Alien Pulse Rifle, they were like, this thing is fucking insane. Mm-hmm. That it has, what, like how many rounds in a clip? Like fucking 50? 99
or 99. Something. 99.
It's a lot of bullets. But like there are, at some point, there are stats somewhere about the gun. Mm-hmm. That it fires a lot of rounds a second.
And each one is a mega uranium depleted supercharged shot or something.
Each one hits with like the force of like an elephant gun. But because it has, I don't know, a thing where it was like, this thing would punch through power armor. It is so much better than like a bolt gun.
Wow.
And they're like, this is for a realistic sci-fi gun. Even though you couldn't make it because we don't have a propellant that can fire a bullet that.
Okay, but just based on its in-universe stats.
Yeah, they were like, this thing is actually like pretty little.
Isn't the smart gun even better? Like, because it's got like it's bigger. It's got like a bionic arm thing that holds it up.
That thing is really cool.
And in the old computer games, it used to just auto-track. It had like an aimbot built.
Yeah. Like it would move like your reticule. Really, really liked it. And When, like, sometimes you see those, they're like camera rigs.
Mm-hmm.
It's fun to pretend like you've got a smart gun instead. And so, yeah.
Mm.
Thank you for coming to my Tom Talk.
Tom Talk. I want to look it up now. Aliens Pulse Rifle. I mean, that's why Tower Strength 5, right? They got pulse rifles.
This thing, super rad.
I mean, it just looks pretty fucking cool as
it
well.
Just
doesn't
looks
it?
Amazing, doesn't it?
And it makes a cool noise.
Yeah, it sounds cool. It looks cool.
It's got a grenade-y. You can duct tape a flamethrower to it.
Yeah, but then again, you know, like this keyboard, I could duct tape a flamethrower to this.
I've never seen it done, so I don't think it's possible.
Someone must have. Although I guess like some of the keys are always going to be pressed then, and so you try and send an email, and it's just like, and you're like, no, oh fuck, I just tried to delete. Nightmare.
Man.
But isn't there like a like a Nerf gun that just looks exactly like that fucking thing?
This one.
Yeah.
It's pretty nice. It's kind of like Hazard Stripes. Always a good look.
It's great, but you know, like repainting that to be be a thing.
Let's do it. I'm on board. Any other cool sci-fi guns?
No, actually, it turns out none of the other ones are cool. Oh, and anyone who was like, oh, I like that gun. No, you're wrong.
Oh,
none of the other
wow.
ones are cool.
The official verdict. It's in.
The Gristle Gun, Existence. We were looking at that
we
last week.
We literally were, weren't we? The Noisy Cricket. It's kind of funny.
It's kind of funny, but...
It's a one-note joke, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the discs.
Is that a gun?
Well, I guess this is weapons.
Oh, okay, sure.
Gristle gun, gross.
Gross.
Oh, yeah, the head bomb. 2 inks.
Pretty good.
Although, like, how does he fit anything in there? Do you remember when the tube comes out of the side of the ear?
Yeah.
And it's like, where's his head?
It's like telescopic.
Oh, right. I never thought much of the Blade Runner gun.
No.
I don't think that's cool.
No, seeing as Harrison Ford, like his Han Solo pistol looks fucking rad.
Yeah, it's like iconic,
like
right?
Like the Mauser thing. Wait, is it Mauser or is it a Luger? No, it's a Mauser.
I think it's a Mauser, but with like a scope on top.
Yeah, they've kind of greebled it up a little bit.
Yeah.
But that thing was a cool pistol.
Yeah. I mean, Robocop's gun's pretty cool. It's
the Beretta, like... right? Some kind of Beretta?
Is it? I didn't even think it was like a real gun. I thought
they did call it like a thing.
Oh. Because I felt like it was like basically a Desert Eagle that fires bursts.
Yeah, the burst fire. Great for fucking shooting dicks off.
So many dicks.
Man, you do. That's like just. You don't want to be hitting the fucking. The Jeepers with a.
Do you remember when they did that remake?
Where it's just everyone
remake.
With their dicks getting shot off. It was so good. We can't show that.
We can't show that clip, but if you ever want to see something. That's not usual. You can watch the R RoboCop remake, where like 50 different teams of filmmakers and animators all took like a scene from the film each and made it in their own way, and you can put them all together to make the whole movie as if it was made by 50 insane people.
It's really good.
And that one scene I was not expecting
was the best scene. God, it just keeps going. It's, but it just doesn't stop being funny.
No, you got to check that one out. Very good. Oh, Pulse Rifle. I need it at number 4, Tom, technically.
Wow.
Do they not know that it fires depleted cased uranium hard point tips?
Yeah, well. But they only have the... Just the pulse rifle. They don't have the flamethrower.
Is that going to be number one?
It's
a combi motion. I mean, proton pack is cooler. It's got a backpack.
Is it cooler?
It's not better. It's cooler.
I don't know if it is cool. I do like the flashy lights.
It's got like, you know, lightning around the lightning that spins around.
Yeah, but they have like one rule of like, don't cross the beams. And then they cross the beams and it actually all works. So... Good times.
Yeah, it turns out they don't know what the fuck they're doing.
No, proton pack is kind of cool.
It makes a cool noise when you turn it on.
Yeah, and I like that it's kind of like a bit drippy as they fire it. That's like a nice stuff. I'm into it. I like proton.
You gotta arc it. You can't just zap it at something. You know, it's kind of out of control.
I feel like the proton pack would actually be pretty legit versus a xenomorph as well.
Yeah, because it just kind of arcs. And it always seems to find its target, no matter how you aim. It's like sentient.
Ooh. They were the ghosts all along.
proton packs don't even kill anything. Well, you never saw them shoot it at a person. You see them shoot it at, like, a library cart, and that thing fucking explodes.
Yeah, holy shit. It definitely...
I think it would pop a person immediately.
Oh, my God. Like, the injuries... Nightmare.
You're getting burned, if nothing else.
I think it'd be really bad.
Yeah, it probably does give you super cancer. That's why they wear these lead-lined suits while...
okay,
while
nice.
...carrying them. That's why they're so out of breath, jogging up the stairs.
Yeah.
At the end.
Yeah, because... You know, lead.
Lead suits.
Okay.
Star Trek phasers?
Fuck off.
At least they chose the slightly cooler one. The next gen ones are the shittest.
Who thinks that's the coolest? No one does.
I mean, every scene where they fight in next gen, it's just them standing there like this. like TV remote.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's so lame. Pew, pew. Do you remember when they had the really small one? It looked even shitter.
Oh.
Star Trek small phaser. It's like a little fucking key fob.
Oh. Beep boop.
They're trying to, like, it's like they're looking for their car in the car park.
You've got to be careful. Like, you're trying to get into your car and you just fucking phaser a hole through the door.
Yeah. Whoops, wrong bipper, I guess.
Oh, shit.
I hate it. It's like the lamest sci-fi weapon of all time.
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah. Set garage door opener to stun.
Yeah, I guess, like, you know, it kind of changes the tone of Star Trek a little bit. If they're like, okay, we've got to go down to the planet. Everyone get your pulse rifles out.
Yeah.
When they start shooting and just people just exploding.
That's true.
Maybe a little.
But then they do later decide to, like, make a big long phaser.
I always thought that this was like a... you know, like a Wii attachment.
Yeah, they just stuck a stock onto a
they
phaser.
They just plug the phaser in because they're like, well, some people want to hold a bigger gun.
Yeah. Is it just for looking more intimidating? Do you think it's got no extra, like, batteries in it or anything?
No. It's that.
Oh, wow.
What was the gun that Guinan has?
Did she have a gun?
Yeah.
I thought she just had, like, fucking
Wii
Kung Fu powers.
There's the episode... Which one is it? People are kicking off, and she gets out a fucking gun and shoots the ceiling with it.
How do you spell Guinan? Yeah, there she is.
Guinan, Star Trek, just gun Guinan. Boom.
Oh, fuck. I don't remember this episode.
And she fires it into the ceiling, and, like, stuff falls down. Like, I feel like firing Mega Blaster.
It's gold.
That's going to get you in a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
On a spaceship. I don't think you're supposed to be firing too many...
No, don't blow a hole in the roof, Guinan. Jeez. Holy shit.
The Magnus III energy weapon, apparently.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I remember this one. Someone's told me to look up the DS9 transporter rifle. Do you remember... You've never seen DS9, right? There's a whole plot where someone assassinates someone by using a teleporting sniper rifle. Like, he can see through to the other side of the space station because he's got, like, a see-through wall scope.
Okay.
And then he fires it at them.
Oh, like in Eraser.
Like in Eraser. But the bullet starts firing and then gets transported, like, with the teleporter to, like, right next to them. It totally breaks the universe. You shouldn't really be allowed. It's total bullshit.
Okay.
Well, there you go. She can see through walls and it's got a little transporter in it. And it's just like, why? How? What? So now anyone can die at any time from anything?
God, they really, like, up the stakes to a pretty high level.
Fucking bullshit.
I was hoping that it was like you shoot someone with a little thing and then it just teleports them, like, 500 meters up.
Well, that would work.
They're just outside of the spaceship. Just fuck!
It's the Chief O'Brien variant.
Yeah. Which I think would be more fun.
That is more fun. Yeah, just tag them with a little transporter thingy. Hmm.
So what's number one? It's going to be Han Solo's pistol, surely. Oh, lightsaber.
I mean, yeah, fair enough. They are the most iconic sci-fi weapon, aren't they? They've kind of been played out now, though. Like, I've been overexposed to lightsabers now, I think.
Yeah. Can you name someone that uses an orange lightsaber, Ben?
Yes. Pullo from Rome.
Does he?
You know,
Titus Pullo. He died recently.
He did. Fucking rest in peace. Race Stevenson. He was a cool dude. I liked him in all the things he was in. He wasn't in enough stuff.
He
died really young.
Who was he?
He's in a new thing. It's not out yet, but it's in the trailer.
Oh. Oh, God, he looks fucking amazing.
Yeah, he's a cool dude. It's not out yet, but I'm excited to see what he's up to.
Kind of orange.
It's definitely orange. It's not red, is it?
Well, Yaddle has one.
Does she? Sorry to take the wind out of your cool orange lightsaber fact. How do you know?
Or maybe it's yellow.
Yaddle lightsaber. I need to... Is it in that cartoon that I haven't seen?
Yaddle.
Wow. These all just look like Photoshops, though. Is it actually canon?
Somewhere it's canon.
Because I want green. It's such a fucking puppet, isn't it?
Here, look. Which Jedi uses an orange lightsaber? They wouldn't lie in this picture. Someone's drawn
that handle doesn't even look real. That's so clearly Photoshopped
I don't know. It was said somewhere. I saw it was on like a YouTube short or something. And it was talking about how Yaddle... It was talking about orange lightsabers and how it was like Plo Koon, Yaddle, and someone else have orange lightsabers.
This just kind of looks like they're holding glow sticks at a rave.
It does look like the lamest rave ever.
I'm amazed this guy with a long neck doesn't ever decapitate himself with a lightsaber doing all them flips.
Yeah, I don't know how many flips that guy's doing.